Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. So, of course, we have this mimic here, which you'll all remember. But there's a ladder behind it, which I didn't actually notice the first time around. So let's take it. I want to know what's beyond this ladder. Is it going to be death? I'm assuming it's going to be death. But the question is it going to be my death? The answer is probably yes, but we'll find out. What is here? A small doorway. Okay. Hang on, is there any secrets here? Doesn't look like it. Okay. I guess we're risking everything to drop down here. Load up. Drop. Huh. Is this the place I found the key before? Oh, I see. Okay, this is where I got in. And down there... Okay, that's the path that people were saying, be prepared to dash. I was like, okay. Fair enough. Lightning bolt! Ooh. That's neat. Check that out. Oh yeah, the Dragon Slayer lightning arrow, which I haven't even looked at. Large spear-like arrows enveloped in lightning, created by the giant blacksmith of the gods, can only be used with great bows. Lightning has been a weapon of dragon slayers ever since the time of Gwyn, the First Lord. Alright, lightning bolt. Bolts imbued with lightning created by the giant blacksmith of the gods. However, the gods never use crossbows. These bolts are likely artifacts of the dragonless era when the pact between gods and humans was upheld. I guess the Age of Fire from the original game. Alright, so... that's the place where people say, get ready to dash. That appears to be an elevator shortcut. That looks like it's the rats from before. Well, we've dropped down in a way that I can't really easily get back up from. And I'm curious. I kind of feel like there's... like, now that I know it's here, I feel like it's worth just... ow, 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 ow. Wow, that was poorly done. Great start. Well, I was right. That was my horrible death. I don't even know if I killed any of them. That... I don't know what I was thinking. Whatever. I've got a shortcut. It's no big deal. I don't think there's a reason to cut out the run back, because I'm pretty sure this shortcut goes straight down to where I was. Like, straight down to where the mimic is, so... no big deal! Let's take the shortcut and end up back where we were. And since I already have the mimic item, I don't see any reason to kill the mimic except, I guess, souls, but... eh. I'll deal with that when I deal with it. I'm not in too much of a hurry for that one. I'm actually getting a lot of souls in this area. This has been relatively productive. I'm not... granted, Cathedral of the Deep was an area I was over-leveled for, so there's that. But on top of that, I just... guess I just never really got much out of it. So anyway, back up here. Yeah, so Cathedral of the Deep, I was over-leveled, but I didn't really farm it a whole lot, so I didn't get a lot of souls regardless. But yeah, even then, an entire run through that may get me enough souls to level up once at this point. Whereas... small sections of Irithyll Dungeon give me enough souls to level up, so I'm okay with this. It's not too bad. I feel there's gotta be a secret. Is there something I'm missing? No, no signs of ladders or anything. Nope, looks like it's really just a matter of go down here and then go up here to deal with all this crap. Give me my souls. All 769 of them. Ah, shoot. Okay. Why am I charging this up? Let's kill you trivially, and everything else should follow soon after. Ah, come on. Gonna be difficult. There we go. That's for being difficult. You get slashed. Alright, what's next? Alright, two crossbows and one of those sickle wielders. It actually reminds me, the crossbows are really easy to backstab. And I could use that FP. Oh yeah, got both of them! Now it's just on you. And I can stun you by rolling, so... Ow. Seriously, these enemies, once you realize you can stun them by rolling into them, become a lot less challenging than they used to be. Not that they were hugely challenging to begin with, but especially when you roll into them. So yeah, this is fine. I don't know why they're telling you to dash. So basically, there's now two areas. There's up there. And there's over here. And that area over there... Okay, that leads to a lower section. Wait a sec, I know where that leads. And it's useless. That just leads back... That bridge right there, that stone bridge right across here, that is... That's where it came in. That is the area I came in. That's where the giant was. I came up there, I went down that ladder, went through that bridge. There's another mimic over in that tunnel. That area is useless to me. Let's go this way. Didn't miss any secrets. I'm probably missing secrets, but let's at least make a nominal token effort to avoid them. To avoid missing them. Oh, wait. I just said what it was. Well, we're back here then. And yeah, it doesn't look like that area is all that much better. But those cages look like they've got to be shortcuts. I don't know. I find that bizarre. Alright, so, that being said, there's actually an easy way back, thankfully. Having gotten rid of all of those hollows, I can just go back up and up the ladder. So it's all good. It's not a big deal. I can try that again. Go through the other area, because that other area is not as easily backtracked from. So over here and down that hole. I don't know why people were saying prepare to dash. I'm not dashing there. I don't need to. Although now at this point I'm starting to feel like I'm reaching something at the end of this area. But I don't know where that end is. That's the thing. And this area doesn't seem to really provide all that much of a boon. I'm just back to where I started. And there are rats there. And otherwise, not much has changed. So, I'm missing something. Let's just think about this for a sec. So, there's a light there. Doesn't seem to be anything. There's stuff up there. There's those rooftops I was just on, where I could drop down from there to anywhere else from the later area with the mimic, if I go down. But of course, that area is accessible. Oh, wait, no, I can't really, can I? I mean, there is a way to get down there. It's just a little annoying. Like, get down there without risking my life. Although, there's that broken section too. So what's that broken section? Like, right down, oh, my mini covers it. Yeah, right over there, there's a broken section there. That's the lower bridge where that rat is. This is hard to figure out. Alright, whatever, let's just take care of the rat. That was easy enough. And more rats, of course, because this area is just full of them. I can't one-shot rats yet, sadly, but it should be fine. Actually, not that big of a deal. Rather mercifully, these rats don't poison me or anything. They just hurt a lot. Shit. Don't give me a chance to heal while I'm trying to figure out where the hell I'm supposed to go. Oh, wait, I remember now. There was actually another area connected to the shortcut that I think was actually down that tunnel. I'll cut out the run back. I'll be back when I get there. All right, we're back. And didn't really discover anything in the meantime, so Continue on. I know there's two giant rats here, which are a pain in the butt, but manageable. They stagger quite beautifully, so I'm fine with that. Yeah, this is the area I was worried about, actually. I went through here and went, oh, crap! Let's deal with this next time! It was, oh, crap, we really should deal with this next... Well, not... I mean, this time, obviously, is the next time. How do you deal with all of those? Crap. No, I don't know. There's too many of them. What do I do? There's too many of them and no way to draw them out. I am so confused. I don't understand this at all. What am I supposed to do? There, like, what options do I have? There's not exactly a lot of splash damage options. And there's nowhere to draw them out to. I don't get this at all. There's gotta be something. Well, I'll cut to when I get there again. That's annoying. Okay, we're back. So again, I am very confused how to deal with this. Maybe you go through here. What the? Oh, okay. That was weird. All right, well, that's one down, at least. Okay, so that presents a valid option, or potentially valid option. This presents another valid option, which is just shoot them. Need to practice my sniping anyway. Especially on moving targets. Oh crap. Get back here. This is gonna be boring. I'm sorry. But there's no interesting way to do it that doesn't get me killed. How many embers do I have? 16. Nope. Not gonna go for it yet. Actually, what I might be able to do, well, I'm gonna just double check there's nothing back here. What I might be able to do is when they go around, is sneak around back and backstab them. Oh. Huh. Okay. What is the dragon torso stone? It's not armor. Is it a ring? Don't see it in here. Is it something I put on from the consumable spots? No. Is it a weapon? This was something that was in Dark Souls 1 that was a covenant item in order to be part of a dragon covenant where you basically turn into a dragon. Apparently they're just giving them away now. But I don't know where it is. Unless it's a key item. Ah, oh. There we go. And it is not a key item. I still haven't found the Pyromancer. Not that I care a whole lot, but I still haven't found the Pyromancer. Apparently they're supposed to be in the cathedral, but I never found them. I never found a way to find them. Well, at any rate. This is annoying. I see no torso stone. I know it's some sort of equipped item, but I can't find it. Okay, this is annoying as heck. I guess I just can't find it. It's clearly not. Oh, wait. There it is. Stone imbued with the power of the everlasting dragons. Used in a secret rite by dragon worshippers. Gain the torso of a dragon and a dragon's roar, a transformation that is irreversible until death. From ancient times, the path of dragon worship was walked by warriors. It is said that they envision Archdragon Peak in the deeps of their meditation, and at times they even hear the distant sound of the great bell at the peak. Okay. And another elevator? Is this another shortcut? Oh, well. Hey! That's neat. Lightning Blade, that'd be a miracle. That's probably give my... yeah. Miracle allegedly wielded by a certain Dragonslayer knight in the Age of Gods. Reinforces right weapon with lightning. Tales of Dragonslayers are now a rare thing, told only in fragments and whispers in remote regions. So I need 30 faith for that, which is the same as Great Lightning Spear, but I'm not super concerned about getting 30 faith until I get to Great Lightning Spear, so let's not worry about that. I feel like Irithel have been doing a lot of running away. Like, find a thing, find enemies, go somewhere else. I feel like that's how it's designed. Like, it's designed to pit you against combat puzzles that, at least when you first get to it, they're not going to work for you. You're going to have to take a smarter route, and then from there, you're going to be able to work out how to get where you want to go. Which is kind of hard for me to do, because I want to hit things. As anyone who's watched my Skullgirl stuff knows, actually, I guess my 0K stuff too, when I do FP VODs, I'm really kind of aggressive. Hey, it is a shortcut. I think it's a shortcut right back to the first bonfire. Oh, not quite. No, actually, it's not quite that merciful. It is a shortcut, though, which is nice. How many souls do I have? 9,000. Eh, who cares? 10,000 souls is not huge. All right, so we found a shortcut. Not that that helped any when it came to dealing with the group of dragons, not dragons, the group of jailers. Let me guess, try mimicry and then secret passage ahead. What? Gesture required ahead. I don't know. The only thing that comes to mind, I mean, there's what look like Legion soldiers here. Okay. Ah, so you're mimicking the rest. No, just close. I get it. Not sure what this is supposed to accomplish, but... wow, this is really frigidy mountainy. How did I get here again? I guess I went through the catacombs and up. But man, this is really out of the way. Hmm. Well, this does not seem to be accomplishing much. I mean, unless it's something like with Bloodborne where you did the gesture. I can't remember the name of it. I'm actually imitating with my arms, but I can't make contact. Make contact with the brain of Mensis, where you have to do a thing for 35 seconds or some length of time. Not necessarily 35, but like some predetermined length of time. I have to be resting here or something before something special happens. I don't know. I tried mimicry and nothing happened. Nope. Gesture required ahead, try mimicry, and then secret passage ahead. I don't get this at all. Like, I'm resting. Unless it's a very specific, is it a specific rest gesture? Oh. It's a specific rest gesture I don't have yet. That's what, or if I do have it, I don't have it prepared. It's like, no, I don't have it. Whatever it is, I don't have it. It's sort of a meditative rest. That's kind of neat. So I guess you meditate there and then go to some other world. I have to remember that if I ever find that gesture. That's kind of neat though. All right, cool. So I guess we have to deal with these things again. Although now they're in the position I want them to be in. So that much is at least a slight relief. Ember. Oh, crap. What? You hit me? Ugh, how did they hit me? They didn't even attack. Ugh. This is impossible. How do you deal with that without just boring everybody? Like, yeah, I could deal with it, but it'd be boring. Whatever. Curious if this run back is, how this run back is now. It's like, how do I deal with it without just nailing everything at range until it's dead? That seems to be the only way to do it. Any other options appear to be suicide. All right, where was that shortcut? It wasn't over there. I'm curious what is over here, though. Maybe I can figure out what it is now. I can, actually. Though, come to think of it, that's not where I wanted to go. But I get this item, so that's cool. And I actually get to see that there's another area I haven't seen at all. Okay, Bellowing Dragon Crest is a spell thing. Yeah. Special ring given to those who are deemed to fit to undertake the journey of discovery in Vinheim, home of sorcery. Greatly boosts sorceries. Apropos to the Dragon School, the seal depicts an everlasting dragon. A bellowing dragon symbolizes the true nature of the consummate sorcerer. Alright, so, and then I stab you. Oh, right, I don't know any way down there. That's not, you know, suicide. Okay. Is there a way down that it's not suicide? No, not easily. Looks like I have to go around. Okay, so that's apparently my goal. It's good to know. I actually have a proper goal this time. I was kind of wandering aimlessly for a little while. But we're nowhere near the shortcuts. I'll just cut to when we get back to where we were. Okay, we're back. I might just crossbow these enemies out because I don't see any other way of dealing with them. If I could, you know, hit. Go stare at that crossbow bolt. Make its health drain. Okay, there we go. Honestly, it's enough if they just come here and their attention is drawn away from the rest of the, or pulled away from the rest of the group. Oh. Why is that a thing? How do I deal with that? It's like, if I hit them, I win. If they hit me, they win. So annoying. So freaking annoying. I don't know what I'm supposed to do about that. Like, I try to hit them first, and then I screw up, and then they hit me, and then I die. I don't think I even got my souls back. Also, I think this is actually the side that I need to be. Oh, no, it's not. Nope, I'm very wrong. This is the side of the maggots. Thankfully, it's also the easier side for this section, because there's only one of those, and I don't know if it'll chase me. It might. I don't care. Much as I do care. Is it chasing me? No. The rest of them are, but that one probably isn't. You die. And I'll just deal with this thing quickly. Alright, and then now we have the shortcut, which is down here. This way. There we go. So yeah, that is how you get to the shortcut. You go across the bridge, and then you go down. But you don't drop to your death. That part is not what you do. I also did not do. So we're good. Jeez, this is annoying. There's gotta be something I'm missing. Some tech I'm missing or something to do with the room I'm missing. I just don't know what I'm missing. Just missing something. Like, there's some trick, I'm sure, to dealing with these. Which maybe the trick is just not to deal with them. I mean, it looks like there's a bunch of side dungeons. And it doesn't look like they really come through the side dungeons all that much. Or they might. Ow, what? Oh, okay. I didn't realize that had a range attack. Now, what the heck are these things anyway? This is a really weird area. I mean, I probably mentioned before that this dungeon's really weird. I guess in a sense it is your stereotypical evil dungeon thing. With random mutant experiment stuff going on, and that's... I guess it's a pretty well-worn horror trope. Yeah. But yeah, that's... Oh, wait a sec, I got coal. Thanks for reminding me, because I had just kind of forgotten among all the other things. Profaned coal, enabled dark, lacerating, and hollow infusion. Remnants of the fire that burned down the profane capital, preserved in an icy skull. Give to the blacksmith in the shrine to allow the use of gems for dark blood and hollow infusion. Alright, so... Yeah, I'm guessing this is meant to be stealth mission. I mean, they threw in all this patrol route stuff. I'm guessing they meant for it to be used. And I mean, hey, if one of them spots me, well, no big deal. If more than one spot me, then yeah, that's a problem. But if one spots me, no problem. Alright, so I'm just gonna go with this is meant to be stealth. Oh, for crying out loud, more of the... I don't want to deal with mimics right now. Eh, whatever. Oh, that was close. Oh, good. I had enough stamina to do that. Titanite scale, yeah! I can upgrade the weapon! And I can upgrade the Faron Greatsword. Where's that? There it is. Yeah! Not the Faron Greatsword, the Wolf Knight Greatsword. I did not get the Faron Greatsword. The Faron Greatsword was the other option. But yeah, the Wolf Knight Greatsword. Ah, oh, great, they spotted me. Are they just gonna keep doing that? Until the end of time, like... Or are they gonna give up at some point? Okay, it looks like they give up at some point. Oh, for crying out loud. Well, they're not coming after me, so whatever. They're not even affecting me. Xanthus Ashes. Cool, more items. Dust Crown Ring, and stuff woke up. Alright, so they don't appear to be coming at me. So Dust Crown Ring is basically, yeah, reduce Leaf-colored crown ring bestowed upon the Princess of Ulysseal, ancient land of golden sorceries. Reduces spell FP consumption, but also lowers HP. Ulysseal is synonymous for its lost sorceries, of which the Xanthus sorcerers are dedicated scholars. This crown ring is a rare artifact of great magic heritage. So I guess a Xanthus sorcerer died back there. Come on, just... There we go. Oh, interesting. So you basically lure them away using that cry. Oh, great, they're still hitting me. And then you can go deal with the rest of this stuff. Alva stuff, whatever that is. Ow, quit doing that to me. Oh, crap. There's another one back here. Wait, there's only one? I can deal with you. I can hit you first. Okay. Once again, I learned the hard way that the better option is, in general, rush. Rush them the hell down. Do that, and you usually get somewhere. Because, I mean, most of these are either dead or so thoroughly distracted that they're of no consequence. I want to use. I think I can stagger this. Oh, not... Yes! Single stamina bar death now. Certainly gotten easier. Alright, is there anything here I'm missing because I can't see? And... Nothing obvious. I wonder how sensitive those enemies are to sound besides just screams of corpses that are pre-programmed. Okay, that was... unwise, the way I did that. But it worked. Stand by it. It's locked. Okay. Can't do that one. Still managed to get through that, basically. I think I got all the things there are. Distracted the jailers thoroughly, and I'm down in that lower section that I spotted earlier, which... There's a trick here. Down to the part that reminded me of Shell of a Sunken City. Where's the thing that's going to drop down and try to kill me? This is an arena-type area. There's an item right here. Is it going to scream? No. Is there anything else coming? Whoa, what's that? I'm suspicious. Profane capital? Oh! Oh! Ow! Okay. Seems to be a relatively straightforward way of dealing with this, which can involve stunning it out and then slashing it to death. Shoot. Oh, come on. Oh, darn it. Ah, oh, finally, okay, phew! All right. It's dead. Probably respawns, but it's dead. I knew it had to be something. Oh, and I called it too, it was the thing on the ledge. That thing on the ledge I was shooting at right there, I thought, that's gotta be something, it totally was. That was what that was, okay. So I wasn't just shooting in vain. That was actually an important thing to do, even if it accomplished nothing in practice. Okay. Here. Man, I hope there's a bonfire here, because getting through those jailers was not an easy task. Oh, hey. It's a ladder. Which I could have taken in the first place had I, you know, turned left instead of right. But, no matter. We can deal with that. Alright, so we have that. We have this profane city. I don't want to know what's going on here, because then that's, I guess, the profane flame stuff that we were hearing so much about. And I'm guessing this is an optional area. Oh, there's the bonfire. Yeah! Awesome. And how much souls do I have? 13,000. Stretch out an undead bone shard. Nice, more undead bone shards. And another gesture that I don't really care about. But more undead bone shards is always good. And I got more embers too. Might as well ember up, actually. Feel like that's a good idea. Can we pass this? No. Alright, so I'm guessing that here was because, well, that's where you make progress. Or you go down this ladder and that gets you to the more of those gargoyles. Admittedly, we did manage to deal with them. But I have upgrades I want to do, so I'm going to do that. Cut back to when I get back.
Lords, where did you happen upon this coal? This is much too dark. I see the abyss in it. Yet, a smith I remain. I won't turn down a request. But forget not. Your fight is for the flame and for your fellow kin, just like mine. A cursed fate this may be, but hope remains, does it not?
Okay, we're back. You saw me give the coal, but otherwise, I also upgraded my, or infused my longsword with the refined gem, so it's now refined longsword, and the Wolf's Knight greatsword plus 3, which is a huge amount of attack rating. And it was a slight increase in attack rating, but it's still worth it to have. It's always worth having it. I believe the attack defense is quadratic, so it is worth increasing even a small amount. It could help a lot. And it all increases with dexterity, and I leveled up dexterity by 1. And I think that's about it. I gave the ashes to the maiden, but they basically just gave me options of 2 different sets of armor. Which reminds me, those are the Alva armor I picked up, and I didn't really touch. Old sorcerer stuff. No, I already did that one. Where is the Alva? Alva. Here we are. Protection of Alva, Seeker of the Spurned. This steel body armor was trimmed to reduce weight. To this day, troubadours sing of tales of the wandering knight, Alva, and his travels, and of his involvement with the saint and the witch. Needless to say, the songs traditionally end in tragedy. Well, hey, the guy beat me twice, so I'm not going to feel too bad. Yeah, okay, looks like they're all the same. And did I get a Xanthus crown? I don't think I did. I think I just got the Xanthus ashes. I did not get the ridiculous yellow hat. Nope. Okay, so that was it. Just Alva stuff. Okay, well, that's that. I am a touch curious. I will check out, before we end this episode, what's down the area that people said here to. I also gotta remember that meditation gesture. I'm gonna write that, make a note of that. Like, actually, literally write that down. Oh, also, do those respawn? They do. All right. It's right there. That's the enemy that swoops down to the bridge. Just wanted to double check, and yes, indeed, they do respawn. Huh, what's down here then? More stairs. Nothing at all, apparently, except a drop. Presumably to one's death. Okay, or a jump. Well, okay, it's attempt to... It's tempting you to jump. It's basically telling you, hey, you're gonna be fine. Don't worry, buddy. And then you fall to your death and that's embarrassing for you. But yeah, that's probably not jumpable. I don't think you have to either. Pretty sure you can just go around the other side. Okay, well, this is no different, but now I can deal more damage. Ow. What the heck? That was delayed. Hey! Okay, so I could have done the critical attack on that. If you hear that like the lower sound when I actually can't really imitate it. When I hit, rather than a higher pitched smacking noise, that means that I could have done a critical attack. And I still get a damage bonus, even though I don't actually get a critical attack outright. Wait, was that the one on the bridge? No, there's still one more on the bridge. That was a different one. It's manageable enough, I suppose. Well, I'm gonna risk it. Wow. Not cool, game. Not cool. Why can't I roll? What is going on? Why wasn't I not able to roll? What was that? I should be able to roll. Okay, that was my bad, but that doesn't change what I said before. I should have been able to roll. Doesn't matter if I'm in muck. It's a fat roll, sure, but it's still a roll. Alright, so there's poison or toxic under here, because there's always toxic under everything. Go down deep enough and there's toxic. Well, this thing is not going to follow me down here, so I don't care. And I want that titanid lizard. What?! Oh, I don't even fat roll, I actually just regular roll. Ah, come on! Let me get that item! Damn it, game! Shit. Oh, it was over there, too. That's how I get out. Can I seriously not jump that? Whatever, I'll just fire at it then. I have a crossbow. What am I doing? Not shooting things. Not ending the episode until I kill that Titanite lizard. Figure out a way. Ha, I knew it was possible. Darn it, seriously? Well, I'm not gonna take that lying down. There, it's like Twinkling Titanite too. Okay, so that's how you're supposed to safely get around this area, rather than the way I chose, which is decidedly unsafe. Okay, that's what I wanted to see. Blooming purple moss clump. Oh, right, alluring skull. I keep that in my inventory so I don't forget to do it for things like, you know, messing with those jailers. Because it's a thing that probably draw them away. But no, I have to forget stuff like that. Eh, well, whatever. I probably should use this sword. Of course. Come on. Ah! There we go. More Twinkling Titanite. I gotta keep my eye on the floor here. That's how I came in. Also, there was a ladder, so I'm not going to be having any problems. There's a ladder. It's all good. Although, before I jumped that, there was another path over here, wasn't there? Oh! Oh, I see. You can jump that if you want, but there's a safer path if you take the cross hallway. You just don't get to easily get the Titanite lizards that way. So that's what those cross hallways are for. All right. Well, that seems pretty terrifying. I think this is a good place to end it. So I'm going to end it here, overlooking this poison swamp. And I hope you enjoyed that. So until the next one, I guess, stay tuned. I gotta figure out a good sign-off. I never really realized that. Good night! Doesn't really work. I don't know, I'm just gonna assume that everyone's sleeping while I'm not doing this. I'm gonna be super narcissistic about this and just say, good night until the next one.